Hello everyone, welcome back. Just another wee quick leg stream here, and it's sort of just to follow up a few questions that was asked in my most recent video there on my scratch coat render, hardest scratch coat render of all. In the background here is, I've played this video particularly as well, me and RFW were just talking about it actually, but it's more the fact of the sand cement background that we've done here, and Metamate's gonna maybe do another bit, very similar, with V cuts out of the render, maybe something a wee bit nicer for everybody to watch. So I might sort of try and make a couple of videos out of it, and stuff. So just wanted to have that on the start of the video here. Gonna try a few things during the video as well, which hopefully won't mess it up. But yeah, so I think some V cuts out of renders videos will be good. Don't think there's sort of, you know, too much on that there on YouTube. Not really sure myself, but yeah, the guy that asked me the questions did ask some very good questions. He basically asked, I put them in the description. He said, when you water down the walls, is it not best to use PVA bond on the walls instead? So that was his first question. Not really sure. Sort of getting a wee bit of a bad stream here, but yeah, that was his first question. If you are watching this later on, and you want to ask any questions, feel free to work away and ask away. The video in the background is also on the channel, of course, with a wee bit of acrylic with V cuts in it. I think that's the title of that video. But like I said, if you do watch this later on, obviously there's a few people watching now, but if you're watching the live stream later on, feel free to come on and comment away, ask questions or put in your what happened to use on them jobs and stuff, how you get on. Even if you're a DIYer, there's no problem, ask away. But so like I was saying, he wanted to know a few questions. The guy that asked, and he asked, when I water down the walls, is it not best a PVA bond on the walls instead? And he said, also, is there something called lime plaster or lime render? So that was his next question. And he says, is that used for outside rendering? I thought lime plaster slash render was a breathable render rather sand cement. I think he meant rather than sand cement. And he asked, what is the ratio mix to your render? And he asked, just normal building sand. You know, they were asked on the how to plaster. I will put that up in the background, just that video, just so I can explain and talk about that a wee bit more. As he was asking them questions on that particular video, so might sort of need that in the background just to make sense of my answers. Pull it up here. Almost give away the wrong video. So yeah, that's the video coming up that he was asking these questions on. So I'll get down to the first question. You could PVA black walls, and the video hasn't changed. You could PVA black walls. And sand cement over it. You could SBR them as well. So this is the wall that he was asking, would it not have been better to PVA it? Although this wall has been built a wee while, it's still new block. There's never been plaster over the top of that block. So PVAing it would probably be a waste of cash on this particular wall. And SBR may have been a better tactic for lower down when the water is going to penetrate, and for the other side where the water is going to penetrate. For a waterproof aspect of things. Also waterproofer, which I did use. Trying to stop water penetrating it is good because it can't get in behind and freeze and pop off your render and crack your render. So that's kind of, just there's loads of tactics, there's loads of ways of doing things, guys. There's loads of ways of doing things right, but of course there's loads of ways of doing them wrong as well. But certainly I could have put some exterior PVA on, that whole wall, painted it on, watered it right down, so you're diluting it, so it wouldn't be as strong anyhow. But I wouldn't have recommended using PVA on this, because that block has good key. It's fresh new block. Well, it might be up a year or so, but it's still fresh. It was hosed down, and the only reason I hosed it down was to slow down. It's a warm day. You can see the sun in the background. It's a very warm day. So the reason it was hosed down was, again, it was just to slow down the suction. Especially it being a wee bit older block, it's going to have suction, and also to control the background suction from the heat of the day. As you can see, it's definitely sun's bouncing. So I think that sort of knocks that first question out of the way, hopefully. But again, if you're ever doing an old wall, you're worried about it drying too quick, I would actually recommend you hose it all down anyway, and then you PVA it, and then you put your coat over. But not that if it's new block that's never been plastered, you should be fine. The concrete block is designed, all the wee sort of holes in the block, the way they're sort of air blocks, some people call them, they're designed for the sand and cement to go in and grip and key. That's its key. It will grip. Trust me, it will grip. If you try to chip it off in 2 years' time, you will find out how well it will grip as well. So that's, hopefully that's that question bothered out of the way. So it's not a bad question, because you could do both methods. So we also asked, was there something called lime plaster or lime render? And is that used for outside rendering? I thought lime plaster / render was a breathable render rather than sand and cement. So I'll just quickly talk about plaster / render. Sand and cement and plaster, basically it's the same thing. You know, sand and cement is plaster. Plaster isn't sand and cement, and like gypsum plaster isn't sand and cement, if that makes sense. That's gypsum, but sand and cement is sand and cement. Both can be called plaster. I've never heard of gypsum being called render all the same. I've always heard it being called plaster. But then I've heard some people who, obviously they're not plasters, would say, like, float up, you know, they would call steel trowel a steel float up your skim, float up your plaster. Where plasters, well, from here, we'll be talking about a float, like an actual float, a polystyrene float or a wooden float or even a plastic float, when we're talking about floats or a sponge float. So there's some differences there. But so he is right, yes, there is lime plasters and there is lime renders. There's lime putty. There's loads and loads of different lime mortars. You can mix sand, cement and lime together. I know a load of guys I met recently, and they swear by putting a bit of lime in their dash. Big guy Jim from Donegal, he loved putting a bit of lime in his dash as well. Personally, I think lime with sand and cement is due to maybe who's taught you, how you've got on with it. I have done both. I have diced with lime. I have dry diced with lime, wet diced with lime. I have used lime silicone renders that are KRen and Weber. There's loads and loads of lime in that stuff. There's loads of silicone in it. Silica, there's everything in it. Silica is a fine sort of a white sand. So there's tons of chemicals in KRen. If you read the back, you probably never get finished reading what's in it. And I don't know if that's everything that's in the likes of them types of Manicouche renders. But so back to his question of lime render. Yes, it's supposed to be breathable. And what does breathable mean? Like KRen, that's supposed to be a silicone breathable
render. So what does breathable mean? Breathable should mean that if it gets wet, the water can penetrate. Although you'll notice with KRN that it'll take a bit longer to penetrate it, as it sort of tends to bead the water off. Not sure if that's to do with it's a ripped surface and there's a bit of dust that throws it back off. But you will notice with KRN, when it does start to get damp, you can see the damp levels in it where it's been splashing and stuff. And later on, if it goes moldy and mossy, you'll see that everywhere. So that way. But yeah, so breathable should mean that the render can get wet and dry out. You know, air flow can get through it and dry out what's in behind. But you know, if you're gonna balance up lime render versus sand cement render, it could be a very, very good video. Possibly a video I will be doing. I might be doing some things to do with both them types of things. But we'll stick the outside when we're talking about lime plasters, lime render. And on this particular job, lime render wouldn't match anything on this particular job. As you can see, what I'm standing on here, I'm standing up high. There's another retaining wall below me, another 5 foot backwards. It's done with sand cement. The whole yard's done round with sand cement, and none of the garden walls are painted. The house is done sand cement and has bands, but it is painted. The house, I think, is 20 years old. So you guys have seen, I've done these sort of walls before as well on the horse stables jobs. So I couldn't go ahead and start doing lime render on this job. Well, obviously the guy that owns the job wants it done with sand cement, but if you did it with lime render, it would look out of place, because it's a wall that's trying to, you're trying to match, you're trying to make it look, obviously this wall looks fresher than the other walls, but you're trying to make it look the same as what's around it, and there'd be no point in me putting lime render wall on and then it's going to dry out whiter, and everything else around it's grey, it's going to stand out for longer. Our care end, it just wouldn't match. So obviously this job's matching what's around it, what walls I'm working to and stuff. You can see up the far right there will be a wall that's rendered that this wall's built onto as well. But whether or not would lime render last longer with damp coming in and out, I wouldn't have thought so, because the wall's built with satin cement, so that theory would be completely busted, you know. The sand and cement inside the wall, then, to people who think that lime render is breathable, then the wall itself is not breathable. It's made from concrete, which also is made from sand and cement. And there might be a taste of lime in it. As you can see, the salt's coming out, the white stains, that's salt's coming out of the cement there, and it goes solid. But again, like I say, if the mortar is all sand and cement as well, so if you know, you're not gonna, by doing lime render on that wall, you're not gonna achieve anything different, as the wall's built with that. Where I do get a lot of questions saying you should use your lime mortar on stonework. But again, if that stone's been built with sand and cement, what's the difference? You know that way. And a guy that's much older than myself. I think he's maybe 60 plaster, and a job coming up that I might be doing, sort of through him, and the guy wants his house done in lime render on the outside, and the plaster who's trying to get me into the job is, phone's going here too, trying to get me into the job is actually trying to talk him out of it. He doesn't want the job done in lime render, and he's a man that's been plastering for 60 years. So you know, if he doesn't see the benefits of it, he actually says lime render dries out quicker than sand cement. He doesn't actually believe so. He thinks sure they'll both dry out, and he believes that lime render will feel just as quickly, if not quicker, than sand cement. But it could all be put to a test in theories later on. So the next question then is the ratio of the mix of my render. and just normal building sand. And if I was going to build the wall, I would use building sand. I would never, ever, ever use building sand for plastering. And obviously, you know, you might have to try these things to learn, but if you try to plaster that wall with building sand, you'll learn very quickly that it's not good. It'll slide. If you do achieve a good finish later on, it will spider crack everywhere. Building sand will shrink more than plastering sand. So you're better with plastering sand. Plastering sand's grittier. The moisture will come out of plastering sand differently than it will come out of building sand. Building sand's a bit more stickier. So there would probably be nothing wrong with a wee bit of building sand in through your plastering sand, but I definitely think if you can stick to good clean plastering sand. Plastering sand's a grade of sharp sand, just a finer grade. But you're definitely always wanting to look for an A-class plastering sand to plaster with. I would never recommend using building sand to plaster. Keep building sand for building. That's why they both have their own names. So that being said, they also asked me for ratios. There's a video in the description down the bottom playlist. I think it has ratios. I did a live stream talking about ratios of wet dash and sand cement. Typically, the backgrounds that I would do would be my base coat, my scratch coat would be a 3-1, and then I'd go for a 4-1. Of course, these can change. You can up them and down them, but obviously your first coat must be stronger than your next coat, always. I've heard of guys who have used 3-1 and then 3-1, who have used 4-1 and then 4-1 over the top of it, and they have their plasters themselves, and they have said that it didn't work. It blew off. So that's them. They learned from that, and they have said, don't do it. It could fail. So if you're going 3-1 and then you're going 4-1, you should be good. If you're going 4-1, then you have to go 5-1 or even 4.5-1 if you want to get really, you know, wee bit weaker, but still not too weak. I have seen crazy mixes, 8-1 and stuff. Other mixes, if you wanted a bit of lime, we shovel a lime into the mix. If that's what you're wanting, go ahead. Another thing is, I did cover this in a video before. People say some plasters, everybody's different, everybody finds their jobs work out different, but some say that 3-1's too strong, and that you should do 4-1 and then 5-1. So some people say that, but you have to remember, if you're going to use mortar mix, plasticizer and waterproofer, this is some people don't know, but it weakens your cement, it kills your cement. So you have to also contemplate what you're doing that way. Also, if you're talking about damp, too much mortar mix, actually for certain jobs you won't even use mortar mix. Mortar mix will be it will void your whole job if you're using it. So you do have to think about what the job is. But this job here, I've done a good few retaining jobs, and I've definitely went for sand cement. You know, if it was a stone job and it was all built with lime mortar, you might want to plaster it the same way. If it's a listed building, you have to follow them regulations. That's what you have to do. If the homeowner that's paying your wages asks you to dice the wall right to the floor, I would recommend you dice the wall right to the floor if you're looking paid. For if you do something different, that's not the job, that's not what he's looking for. It's you know, so obviously I'm not saying somebody says, you know, bought and skim my wall outside, is I gonna pay you money to do it? You don't have to do it at the same time, you don't have to do it wrong. But if it's not wrong and that's what they want, you can walk away by all means. And again, you don't have to follow, if people, like a lot of people sort of coming on my channel and saying I would do it this way and I would do that way, that's fine. Everybody should do it the way that works for them. But of course, if you're wanting to learn what way I do it, you're definitely in the right place. Because I'll always do it the way that suits me and works for me best. And I'll always recommend that every plasterer, DIYer, and apprentice or any tradesman should always do what works for them. I'll always say that. But so I just wanted to wrap up them questions there, and I think that's them sorted. I think I've cleared his questions, and I haven't got any more questions in, so I think more or less that's us done here. Appreciate everybody watching there, guys, and if you want to go onto the channel there, you'll see the original video that I was talking about, and you can even see the original questions and stuff. Feel free to add in your own questions later on. I have no problems answering. Thanks for the support, guys, and watching, and I'll catch you on the next video.